It's becoming into a system, and I think we get to help lots and lots more animals.
When we came a year ago, you were just moving some dogs from the mid road or the dog shelter on Tepkesefri Road near the airport. Do you think this has been a good move overall, that to have your own place here?
Yes, I think it's definitely a good move, because now we're free to operate as we think fit, and we were more selective about bringing dogs in, so all the dogs that are here are really healthy.
Yeah. Yeah. Tell us about these guys you're holding, first of all. Tell us, these are lovely, beautiful, snow-white color.
On Thursday afternoon, when we were closed in the evening, somebody drove up and dropped these three puppies off. And then in the morning we found...
Anonymously? Or?
Anonymously, nobody knows. And then in the morning we found two of them was running around, and so we picked them up because we were afraid that it will get ran over by a car. And the other one ends up in the drain, in a really small drain. And so the next day we tried to hose.
So they were filthy, dirty then?
Yes, yeah. Yeah, but now they all have their prevention against tick and fleas, and they all get their shots.
How old are they?
They're about 2 months old.
So is this sort of normal? Is this what happens? People come and bring the stray dogs, or you go out and you actually find them yourself?
Usually we have a truck that goes out and help pick up dogs and find dogs outside, and we do that on a regular basis every day, and to bring them all to sterilize. And but these puppies, we try to avoid bringing in puppies, because since we're in the location is not convenient for rehoming, people don't come here a lot, so we try to avoid puppies. But this one, we can't because it's been dumped in front of us.
And you are now looking for homes for these type of puppies here?
Yes. We'll go same size of these. We have 15 of them right now waiting for home.
It's not just you yourself, it's a big operation here. You've got volunteers like Julius. Tell us about how you get volunteers and how you try.
Usually we have a website, and volunteers, when they heard of us, they contact us via Kunjan, and then they just come. And then like Juliet here, she actually drove here.
Juliet, tell us your long story all the way from Belgium, is it?
Yeah, I come from Belgium. I'm a vet, and we are two of us, my boyfriend and me, come from Belgium all the way with our car. We come with a camping car. It's a pickup with a cab on it. We sleep in it, we cook in it, and we drove all the way from Belgium to Thailand. And it takes us 7 months, and we have still a little bit of time to go to Australia. And during our trip, we work for those shelters, organizations that help animals, also wildlife and so on. And we are glad that we can help organizations like Soydog and so on, because they do a really great job.
You are fully qualified, experienced vet already.
Yeah.
We've seen you doing some operations. Tell us some going on behind us, mainly sterilization, but tell us you're also operating on a pregnant cat as well?
Yeah, with the support of sterilization, because if the dog catchers go out to catch the dogs, we take all we can, puppies or adult dogs, pregnant dogs. We can't see from far if they are pregnant or if they are too young or something like that, and maybe we only have one chance to catch them, so we take them. And then if the puppies are too small, then we don't do them. But pregnant bitches and pregnant cats, we do them, because it's like an abortion. We do it by sterilization, because the kittens aren't born yet, so they don't really live. So
and the other dog we can see behind, that's having a amputation, is it?
Yeah.
Leg. Tell us about that one.
That one is from Wat Sam Kong area. He lives in an alley, and from what I heard, one of our volunteers called in and said that he got hit by a car a couple of weeks ago, and when we bring him in, we took him to x-ray because he's lifting his front paw, and then we found that he's broken his front leg, yeah. And what happened is that he also have like a joint problem because it damages the nerve, and he's been dragging it and then causing terrible wound infected. So what we're doing now, we have to amputate to stop the infection.
Three-legged dog.
Yeah, and
just like the other one we heard about Christmas, yeah?
Yes.
Three-legged, just gone to America already?
Yes, Christmas is happily living in America, yeah, in the States. And but this one, because the monks at the temple is quite a dog lover, so we're going to take him back, and he said that he's going to take good care of it.
Julia, what do you think about the facilities, especially for operations? Do you think they're adequate, healthy? Any other important aspects that you think they need, or
that they're really good? Yeah, you always need more because they do really great job. There are 2 full-time Thai vets, and they operate until 20 dog sterilization in one afternoon, and they do it from Monday to Friday. So it needs equipment and material to sterilize, because if you do a lot of jobs, cats and dogs on one day, you need a lot of material, also medicaments and to treat them. But because sterilization is the only way to prevent a big population of dogs, and contraception doesn't help, so they have to sterilize, and the operation is the only thing.
Do you think the equipment and the medical supplies here are sufficient?
Sufficient for what they do now, but we only always can do more. And if there are more volunteers coming to help them, with 3 vets is a little bit too small. And if there is a vet more, then you can easily put a new room to sterilize.
I see, Tui, you have lots of sponsors already on the signs for the shelters you've got outside. I mean, 6 Senses particularly, but lots of individuals too.
Yes, we do. They donate money from abroad, and sometimes they're local, that they think, like the salas that we have just put in, they're donated by a German couple who's living here. Yeah, and then they try to gather donations and then put a sala so that the dog won't be in the heat too much.
You still welcome more sponsors like that, naming of shelters or in other ways? How can you do it? How can you attract more in this difficult financial climate?
I think what you should do is that most people, they come in and see what we do, and they think that if they're doing a good job, they tend to help, because they know that we're really doing it, and we're, as the figures and everything shows, it means that we can do more with more donations.
How many dogs and cats? How many dogs first have you got here?
Right now we have about approximately 200 dogs with us, who's like a resident dogs. But we also bring in extra for treatment, and some of them has been abused, and which we think that we will keep with us in the future.